We're pulling into the roundhouse, boys and girls. Yep, I can see old Muley in the window, standing at the switch.
Back up!
Waving at old number nine. Say howdy to Switchman Muley, boys and girls.
Hello, boys and girls. Glad you stopped by to have lunch with me today. Engineers won't let me eat with them anymore. They say I'm touched. Well, you don't think I'm touched, do you, boys and girls? No, we're going to have lunch today, and then maybe we're going to see some cartoons and maybe a Three Dummies movie for you. But first, I want you to ask your ma if it's all right to bring your lunch down in front of the TV set. Didn't have no TV set when I was a boy. Didn't have no mother, neither. Run down by the Florida Limited, which my pa was driving at the time. But I think I told you that yesterday, boys and girls. Let's just see what we got for lunch today. Well, oh, bust my britches. I got poached turbo almondine and a Dijonais mustard sauce and a bottle of Beaujolais. I asked for peanut butter, boys and girls. What'd you get? Probably got a bologna sandwich, if you're lucky. More than I got when I was a kid. All we had was warm Kool-Aid and cold beans. Depression went real hard with me, boys and girls. But I told you that, so let's just eat lunch and let's look at that Three Dummies film I promised you. Whew.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air, starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Catherine O'Hara, Dave Thomas, and featuring Harold Ramis. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network.
Your country thanks you for a job well done. We salute the heroes, their courage is our guide. The American veteran is our nation's pride.
The sacrifices our veterans have made for this country is something Americans should never forget.
Make pleasure boating a real place. Watch for the next announcement for a class near you.
Three blind mice.
Hello.
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 Hello. Oh. Stop it. You're breaking my leg.
What's the matter with you? Fine, get the equipment.
When I'm good and ready.
Oh, when you're good and ready.
Yeah.
Well, that's different.
Oh.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Fine, get out there.
Are you gentlemen from the exterminators?
Back your straight.
No. Are you pick two?
One, two. Pick two.
One, two.
Yeah. Oh, you think it's funny, do you?
Yeah.
What are you picking on him for?
Oh, hero, are you?
Yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
Madam, I think these are the exterminators.
Hey, Abba, Abba.
Calm down, you alley cats.
Where are you boys, Toots? Where's the mice?
You're supposed to find them, you idiots. Now hurry up. My guests will be arriving any moment. Say, I thought I told you dummies this was a classy affair. You can't go into a party dressed like that.
Say, relax, Toots. We came prepared.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I know she's gonna like this.
Nobody's gonna know we're exterminators.
Yeah, we'll be as quiet as a rat.
Oh, I should have been an engineer.
The union wouldn't let me. Said I was catched. Unions think they own the railroads. They're just a bunch of Bolsheviks. Learn how to drive! I think that guy's a Bolshevik, boys and girls. But forget it. I think my lunch break's almost over. And I want to take a look at some of the drawings you've been sending, old Muley. Ooh. Well, these are the worst ones yet. You sure send old Muley some pretty bad pictures, boys and girls. Probably send the good ones to people you like. Well, that's all right. But I've been kicked from Bangor to San Bernardino. And I'm still here. Just a standing at my switch. Yeah, kids used to come down to the roundhouse and wave to old Muley. Bet you go to the airport now and wave at the pilots. I should have been a pilot, flying a big bomber to Berlin. But they said I was catched. I would have bombed those Bolsheviks too, boys and girls. It's Pilot Muley. He's standing at his controls, ready to bomb Berlin, and then on to Borislava. Those Bolsheviks would get a real bunch of bombs from me. I'd be in a DC-29. I'd be flying. President Roosevelt would phone me up on the radio. He'd say, Muley, you're doing a fine job, but you're touched.
I'm Floyd Robertson.
And I'm Earl Cannonbear.
And this is the SCTV News. Today's top story, chaos reigned this morning on the set of TV's Truth or Consequences after host Bob Baker went berserk, killing four people and seriously injuring nine others. Thanks to our local affiliate, SCTV in Los Angeles, here's how the incident looked to millions of viewers earlier today.
I ask you the question, and if you get it right, you'll win a fabulous trip to Hawaii. But if you get the question wrong...
I've got to pay the consequences. I know. I watch this program all the time. Jewel of the Buzzer comes on. And that's it with me.
Right.
They carry me away. Okay.
Right. Then you'll have to pay the consequence.
Okay.
So, get set. Here's the question. What do you get when you mate a dodo bird with an alligator?
I don't know, an alley bird?
Get with it. No, you get Dodo the alligator.
Dodo the alligator.
Who writes this junk?
What's my consequence, then?
I'll show you your consequence. How about a little sulfuric acid in your eyes? You guys are out. I'm sick of doing this show. Ah! All right, I got a gun. Come on.
When asked if he would still be hosting the Miss Junior America pageant next month, Baker replied, "Yes, without question. It's just Truth or Consequences I got a little tired of." Unquote. Earl?
Well, it was a day of fun in the sun today as the International Association of Terrorists held their annual picnic at Lloyd Thurston Park. French potato salad, sandwiches from Lebanon, and even some Turkish beer were only some of the delectable picnic treats brought in from all over the world. Violence and political aspirations were the topic of the day, but there was always time for an old terrorist yarn or two. Only one dark cloud shrouded an otherwise perfect afternoon. A flare-up with members of Local 219 of the Tool and Die Workers over who had control of the baseball diamond. Kelly Fatan and Yosa Labu of the Black September organization tussled with Art Cole, a foreman of Local 219, claiming the Tool and Die men had been on the diamond for over 3 hours, not allowing the terrorists any time to play. By the time the argument was settled, 12 people died horrible deaths. But all in all, a pleasant afternoon for the guerrillas and their families. Blood?
Before I sign off tonight's newscast, Earl, I've been wondering about something.
What's that, Floyd?
Well, your name is spelled Camembert with an M, as in Mary. But it's pronounced Cannonbear with an N, as in Norman. And I was just wondering why.
just the way I pronounce it, Floyd. Let's see. And that's the news.
Don't you mean, and that's the muse? This is Telly Savalas for your local boys' club.
Tuesday at 5:30 on TV 12.
20 years ago, Luke, we're closing in on a killer.
Coming soon.
Well, I said we'd have some visitors today, and it's Miss Taylor, the social worker.
Is he under arrest or what?
Well, he is under arrest, Mr. Parker, and you're just in time to watch me take down his statement.
Oh, Mr. Bendy, don't forget to read him his rights.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Are you bad boys and girls?
Then watch out. You could turn up on Officer Friendly's Most Wanted list on SCTV.
This season on SCTV, a diner in the future where the food gets dished up at warp speed. It's two of your Star Trek favorites, Spock and McCoy, starring in a new situation comedy called Check, Please.
Spock! Where the hell are you? Maybe Vulcans like their food cold, but just about everybody else in the galaxy likes their food hot.
Doctor, casual observation would indicate that I only have two upper appendages. Perhaps a more efficient system of food preparation would facilitate my distributive function.
I suggest you exercise your distributive function, Spock, by getting your lower appendages in gear. Now get that anti-gravity soup and those meatballs over to table four.
Parenthetically, Doctor, I just said something to a customer that I believe you humans would classify as humorous. It seems that a Malkotian leopard fly landed in his soup, and when the customer inquired what the fly was doing there, I very cleverly replied that it appeared to be performing an octopedal variation of the Klingon backstroke.
That's hilarious, Spock. But as you know, everybody in the galaxy, along with me, knows that Vulcans aren't funny. So why don't you just shut up? Can't you see I'm too busy for your humorless dribble?
That's Spock and McCoy together again on Check, Please, Tuesdays at 9.
No hope for prison. Tell me, Tommy, did they make you mean, son? Did they make you mean, angry, son? Did they beat you and make you fight me? Are you nothing but a fighting mean hunk of angry, mean bully, Tom? Tommy, you vicious mean soldier, Tom. Tommy, you mean bully.
Ma! Tom. Ma! I'm not mad at no one. No? Oh, now, what's going on here?
Oh, we're leaving California. Oh, Tom, the mudstorms have been so bad. We can never use the pool or the tennis court no more.
The winds are whipping up now, Tom. You want to see a mudstorm? You just take a look.
Tommy. Oh, wipe it up,
Tom. He's out of prison and he gets hit with a mud pie, I tell you.
Now, Tommy, don't get mean, nasty mean. No more vicious Tommy.
Ah, shut up, Ma. I don't know. Boy, I tell you, the place sure looked a mess.
Oh, Tommy, the Japanese gardener up and left.
Where's everybody going?
We figured Oklahoma would be a good dry place to go. See, lots of Californians are heading there, Tom. After all this mud, that dust is going to feel real good.
Yeah, when I get to Oklahoma, I'm going to get me
get a big handful of Oklahoma dust, and I'm going to pour it all over my head, Tom. Yep, yep. And then I'm going to roll around in that mud, and then I'm just going to mush a big handful of that mud in my face. Then I'm going to get me a Oklahoma chicken fried steak. No, I'm going to get me a whole mess of Oklahoma chicken fried steaks, and I'm going to grab me a big handful and just mush them into my face.
And that mush.
Oh, Tom, you mean. You're a hunk of vicious mean angry.
Look, if you're going to Oklahoma, you better get started.
Okay. I'll go in the back, Mom. Okay.
I'm going to get me 10 chicken fried steaks, and I'm going to wear them like a hat. Then I'm going to make some sandals out of chicken fried steaks. Ooh, and then I'm going to get me a whole mess of cold flying.
Ain't you gonna look back at the old place, Mama?
We're going to Oklahoma, ain't we? So let's go.
Well, I'm gonna look back. Well, let's go to Oklahoma. Ma, see if you can get someone on that CB.
Break one now, break one. Come on, this is flat busted.
Flat busted?
Hey, ain't that the preacher up there on the road?
Where are you folks headed?
Oklahoma.
Mind if I ride along?
Not at all, but you have to sleep in the back with my daughter.
That'll be just fine, ma'am. I was a man of the cloth until I lost the calling.
Well, maybe you just misplaced it.
You're a bright girl, Rose O'Sharon. I see you got the seed of life a-growing inside you.
No, I'm just pregnant.
My mistake.
Yeah, we must be pretty near Oklahoma now. How's Gramps doing, Rosa Sharon?
Poorly, Tom. Preacher says he might not last the night.
I'm gonna get me a mess of chicken fried steaks. Put one in each pocket.
Well, I wish your grandpa would live to see this.
I guess a trip was too much for him.
Tommy, don't you think we better bury him or cremate him or something?
He told me last night he wanted to be chicken fried.
Chicken fried? Rosa Sharon, you better get the big frying pan. Preacher, would you like to say a few words for us?
Oh, ma'am, I lost the calling.
Well, you were a preacher, weren't you?
I lost the calling.
Well, I'll just say something.
All right, Lord, I know you love poor people because you made so many of them. I didn't know this man too good, but I know he was poor, Lord, dirt poor. He was nothing much to speak of, just a dirt poor old nothing. He was less than dirt. He was
all right, preacher.
Nothing. He was lower than dirt. He was low down, grimy piece of slime.
Preacher, hey, preacher, lighten up.
Amen.
Well, I'm gonna get me a job dusting crops. Hey, mister, you know where a fella goes to find a job around here?
Ain't you Tom Jordan?
Muley! What are you doing here?
It's Mr. Mule now, Tom. A few weeks after you left California, I picked up this leaflet. It said scabs wanted to bullet poor migrants. Easy work, good pay, only goons and hooligans need apply. You know, Tom, my mother's maiden name was Hooligan.
Well, I just want to dust crops.
Okay, Tom, I'll give you a job. Here, you can dust off that alfalfa, and when you finish with that, you can start on the wheat. Well, don't go missing those corners, neither.
All right. Say, what's his job pay anyway?
Well, Tom, I can start you at a penny a day, but tomorrow it goes down to a half penny. Day after that, you have to pay me.
Now, that don't seem hardly fair. Man can't support a family on that.
That's socialist talk, Tom. Boy, you Reds really burned my bridges. You think this land is urine? Well, it ain't urine. Owning it, renting it out, subdividing it. That, this piece of paper, that's what makes it urine.
That makes me mad, Muley. That makes me mean mad. That makes me mean, mad, nasty. Fighting bad, mad, bad.
It still don't make it urine.
Ah, you... Ow! Done it this time.
We'll be back with more Disco Farming right after this. Whenever our chef starts to decorate food, everyone wants the secret. Crowds gather to watch an apple become a swan.
Richards of Menaki, USA, with proof that a good 30...
Get free Kodak film by using your credit card and calling 1-800-331-4545 or send $20 plus $385 shipping and handling to Menaki, USA, Box 8325, West Palm Beach, Florida, 33407.
How old do you think I am?
What? Yeah.
Ah, wake up! Wake up!
Tommy!
You're having a bad dream. Ma, where's Rosa Sharon?
She ran off with the preacher, Tom. I guess he found his column. Tommy, what's wrong?
Well, Ma, you remember Muley? Mm-hmm. Well, he called me a Red.
Oh, Tommy, did it make you mean, man? Mean, vicious, angry, perturbed, Tommy?
Bet it did, Ma. Made me so mad, I killed him. At least I think I did. I hit him pretty hard with that feather duster.
Tommy, what are you gonna do now?
I don't know. Police are gonna be after me. I'm gonna have to leave Oklahoma, Ma. Besides, the mud's catching up with us anyway. I'm gonna go to Arizona where it's dry.
Well, Tommy, ain't I gonna see you again?
Oh, Ma, don't worry. I'll be around somewhere. Wherever the little people are being taken advantage of, I'll be there. Wherever some big bully's pushing around some little guy, I'll be there. Wherever the little people are, that's where I'll be. The little people. I'll be with the little guys. They can be big, too, and still be little. I knew a few fat little people once. Big, fat little people, but they were little people. Sometimes you can be big and be a little person.
Well, Tommy.
Little when you're big.
You better get moving if you want to beat the mud.
Oh, don't worry about the mud, Ma. It's not going to be here for a while yet.
Look out, Tom!
Dang.
Well, you better get going.
This valley, they say you are leaving. Not hinting in you do.
Just remember the red river valley and the cowboy that loved you too. For a long time, my darling.
Presenting the rewards of taking 385 shipping and handling to Menaki, U.S.